Hello all, welcome to Instacart Holdings, your worldwide instrument partner. Now I'm going to walk you through the product M8 M1 Multiple Use PDF Temperature Data Logger. This data logger is mainly used to detect temperature of food, pharmaceuticals, chemicals and other products during transportation or storage. This data logger has got a main features like it is a multiple use one and automatically generated PDF report, and this is a high waterproof level which is IP67 rated. And the battery is internal battery CR2032 and which is an exchangeable battery. Coming to the technical parameters of this product, it has got a temperature range of minus 30 degrees Celsius to plus 70 degrees Celsius with an accuracy of plus or minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. It can also be recorded with temperature range in Fahrenheit with a range of minus 22 degrees Fahrenheit to plus 158 degrees Fahrenheit. And the recording capacity of this data logger is 32,000 measurements, and this is a ready to use data logger, and it has also got a integrated USB port. This is the USB port for direct PC connection, and additional features like multi-level thresholds, and this has got a multifunctional LCD display. This is the LCD display, and the data logger has got MKT calculation, which is mean kinetic temperature calculation, and multi-trip capable. This data logger is a multi-use data logger, and temperature accuracy is adjustable for this data logger, and you can also adjust the sensor adjustment in very critical conditions. And this data logger is GDP compliant and also EN12830 compliant data logger, and it has got a battery lifetime of at least 6 months at 25 degrees centigrade if recorded interval is 15 minutes, and report type is encrypted PDF file. And this temperature data logger can also the sensor type is for this data logger it is internal, but based on the application you can also use external data logger with the external sensor type. And coming to technical, this is the sort for battery. You can see here, this is a model number of this, part number, and this is the serial number of the data logger. This is the LCD display, and there are two keys. This is to on, this is to start the data logger, this is to stop. And you can see here battery indication, this is the current temperature in degree centigrade. This is in the pause mode, so it is showing like this. This is the log, how many recordings it has recorded till now, 492. This is the maximum temperature recorded in degree centigrade, minimum temperature. What is the higher limit, higher alarm we have set, that is 28.0, low, 26.5, it is for low indication. Now it is that the current temperature is 26.0, and which means like at some point it is over than the higher limit and at some point it is less than the lower set point. So as per the recordings recorded till now, it is showing both the indications. And this is the display, and this is the cap provided for this protection of USB. And this data logger has got many other parameters which can be set using the software. This is the software used for this temperature data logger. Here you can see when it is connected to the PC, here it is showing USB. And it is password protected. Here you can see the summary. Like device information, temperature type, in which mode it is there, in degree Celsius or in Fahrenheit. And this is the start mode. This is the start delay. Based on your application, you can set this start delay. This is the log interval, which I have set previously as 2 minutes. And now the device is on the stop mode. So it is showing device state as stop. You can set the time zone as per your time. Multiple start. And the probe mode is internal, as the sensor is internal sensor. and description, the temperature recording. Here you can see the logging summary, which is the highest temperature till now recorded, which is previously shown in the display, and the same will be shown in the software also. Lowest temperature, average temperature of these highest and lowest, or with the all the recordings. And this is the mean kinetic temperature value. And you can stop the data, stop the recordings by two ways, one with the software and one with the manual, like with the keys, which I have already explained you. This is the data points, 492. This is the start time, when we have started and when we have stopped the data logger. And this is the elapsed time, which means the total time which has spent, like which in which the data logger is like in on condition, in which the recorded. And this is the H1 at the higher higher point of time, with time. Like if I set for 27, how many times the data logger has got this temperature? This is the number of violations, and same as for the lower one. And you can download here. At every stage, it will ask for password. Have to save the data. As I previously saved, I am not saving it. And you can export the data in three ways: Excel format, PDF format, and ELT format. You can also import the data in ELT format, which is in ELT format. Now I'm exporting the data. To PDF format. Now it will open the dialog box, save. Here you can see the report in PDF. With all the details of the device, the serial number, everything, temperature type, which we have seen on the software. You can see the data in both graphical form and tabular form. This is the tabular form, and here you can see this is the normal temperature. If it is red, this is beyond the set point, higher set point. If it is blue, lower, less than the lower set point. Same will be shown in the graphical format. At what particular time, what is the temperature? Here you can see. And this is the same same data which is shown in the previous software version. And this is the in PDF form. You can also export the data in Excel form also. Now I'm setting the parameters. This is the display to set the parameters. Here you can set the log interval in minutes, in hours, and in seconds. Here you can set a password. If you want the password, you can set. If you don't want the password, no password, you have to click. Can set the password. This is like temporary report. If you connect the data logger to your PC, if you put this as enable, automatically PDF will be generated. If you put disable, the PDF will not be generated. And can also, as I previously told, the feature of this is multiple thresholds, multiple alarms. Here you can set 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, like 5 alarms. If you want the repeat alarm, you can set here single or cumulative. You can also set the alarm delay. This is the start time. You can start the data logger by three ways. You can start like right now. Here you can see start mode right now. As soon as you remove the data logger from the PC, the data logger will be started. Start by button means like a manual intervention, which is the key. This is the key for starting the data logger. And timing, you can set the data logger to some set of time. After that, the data logger will be started. Stop. For stopping the data logger, there are two modes: stop by button or stop by software. This is temperature unit. You want the data to be recorded in degrees centigrade or degrees Fahrenheit. And this is the time zone. Based on your timing, you have to set this time zone. And display time. If you want the display time forever, have to set this in the software. Multiple start or stop. This is like when you want to stop the data logger after a particular period of time, and if you want to start the data logger again after 5 minutes, you have to set here. It can be set with multiple start or stop. And these are the parameters we can set in this data logger. You have to save. Whenever you are going to set the new parameters, the previous data will be erased. The start time is like less than the current time, so it is the features, the settings which you have done is not saving. As I explained previously, this is the failed because the month is 3, the date is 3, now I have set for 4, have to save. Now all these parameters are set, completed. This is the certificate validation, which is generated, like it is automatically PDF generated. So it will generate this. This is the reference instrument. This is the serial certificate number. This is a 6-point validation information of this data logger along with the serial number with the environment conditions, like it is a calibration certificate. And coming to database, this is the summary page which I shown previously. If you want to delete this, you can delete here. You can select number of devices, or like whatever the devices you are having, you can select and you can delete here. And it is also having the restore backup. If you delete here, it will restore the data. And these are all the software configurations of this data logger. As I explained you previously, you can see the data here in graphical form. This is the graphical form and in tabular form with the timings and with temperature, with ID and with all this in graphical form. See here, zoom in, zoom out. These are the indications of zoom in, zoom out of, if you want this particular temperature, you can zoom here. This is the ID with the temperature and with the time it is showing. And this is the, here you can see the threshold mode. What is the higher set point you have set with the lower? Save. You can save this graphical data. These are the software software configurations, and this data logger comes with a validation certificate from manufacturer. This is the certificate of validation. This is the carrying case of this data logger. For more technical details and direct purchase of the same and similar kind of data loggers, you can visit our website www.instacart.com. Thanks for watching.